Tornado warning has been issued for that particular storm. The warning goes until 5:45. This thunderstorm that's been moving southeast across the northern part of PG County is tracking down toward the areas in Anne Arundel County, from Bowie in PG County to areas down in central and southern Anne Arundel County. It's moving southeast about 25, 30 miles an hour and may well have a tornado associated with it. Radar definitely shows that couplet that we look for here with the red and the green coming together. So that's the potential for a tornado there just to the west of Bowie. This is the storm here that we're concerned with. And as I put it in motion, you'll see that it's tracking south and east. So it's not a threat to the immediate Baltimore area, but it is going to look like, if it holds together, get over into parts of Anne Arundel County once it passes Bowie and then moves down to the south and east. So be on the lookout in this area if you're watching us down there, coming across the Bowie area and then moving down south toward Queen Anne, right on the Bowie Anne Arundel County line. I think these areas here should be taking shelter right now, getting out of the way of this storm as it makes its way south and east. Looks like it's about to cross Route 50 there, just south of Bowie, and then move to the south and east fairly quickly, moving kind of quickly, but that definite signature there that would indicate a possible tornado with that thunderstorm in the Bowie area. Let me see how high up this one is building. Sometimes we'll get a feel for how strong it is. It does not look all that impressive as far as its upward motion goes. The storm is only building up to about 33,000 feet, which is a decent thunderstorm, but nothing extreme, at least by this standard. But the signature is pretty clear that this thunderstorm in the area of Jericho Park now in northern Prince George's County and just to the west of Bowie could possibly have a tornado associated with it. There you see the location that we would be most concerned with this storm system. With the we're looking at the Sterling radar right now. So these red areas here are winds blowing away, and the green are winds blowing toward the radar, which is down around northern Virginia near Sterling, Virginia, Dulles Airport. So that system there looks pretty significant as far as a signature on radar to indicate there could well be a tornado there. 72 mile an hour shear, 48 mile an hour wind speeds, and that's aloft. The radar beam is hitting this storm a few thousand feet up in the air, most likely. So just near the Bowie area, tracking south and east, warnings have been issued for a possible tornado. You want to get to the lowest level of your building for sure. Get out of this storm. Wait till the sound of it passes by from Bowie down to the south and east toward Queen Anne. We will certainly monitor the progress of this storm. It looks like it'll pass safely to the south of Annapolis, but if you're in Anne Arundel County there in the southern part of the county, be on the lookout for that storm system that's moving out of PG County and will quickly track down into that location. So Queen Anne, certainly there. Anybody along or Route 214 there, east of 301, north of 214 and south of Route 50. That would be the prime area here in this location that could be impacted by a thunderstorm that may have a tornado associated with it even as we speak. This is the motion of the storm, again, south, northwest to southeast, right through the Bowie area. If you're in that area and you see something, let us know. But for now, until the storm passes, you want to be taking shelter for sure and not risking going out to look at this storm system until it passes by. The typical safe rooms that we talk about on these storms are interior parts of your house, lowest level. If you have a basement, you certainly want to get there. Sometimes under a stairwell would be a safe spot to go. In the middle of the house, away from windows, a bathroom on the lowest level is usually one of the safer areas in a home. And of course, if you have a basement, then that would be the ultimate place to go is in a basement. Certainly underground is the best. You stay away from windows because of flying debris, and you get to the middle of the house seems to be the most sturdiest place. And a bathroom sometimes, or a closet, cover your head, wait for the storm to go by. We're saying this because of the tornado warning that has just been issued for PG County and Anne Arundel County, going until 5:45 for that tornado warning. Nobody has seen it yet, but the radar indicates, strong indication on radar, that there could be a tornado in this area as it moves across the Bowie area. We monitor these storms a lot of times with our radar, and this BWI is not coming in yet. There's the radar indications, and again, that's from Dover, Delaware. So the winds there are blowing toward Dover and away from Dover, indicating circulation in that location. And then we use the Sterling radar. It looks like it's falling apart a little bit here, so they may well cancel this as it tracks south and east, but enough of a signature to be concerned with and to take precaution. So again, if you're in this area of Anne Arundel County, right near the PG County line there, north of Queen Anne, south of Route 50, you want to be taking shelter now and wait for that powerful thunderstorm to move by. Most likely is going to be pushing fairly quickly through the area and perhaps weakening a little bit as it moves to the south and east. Don't see a whole lot of lightning strikes showing up right now. So again, that's a good sign that it's not strengthening. And the echo tops on this one are not that high. So again, another good sign that it's not getting any stronger than it is right now. But the potential for that storm to build up over 30,000 feet. Tornado warning then for PG, the eastern part of Prince George's County, western and southwestern parts of Anne Arundel County, for a storm that's tracking southeast from Bowie toward Queen Anne's. Looks like it's about ready to cross Route 50 now and hopefully weaken as it moves south and east. There was another tornado earlier this afternoon down in eastern Virginia. So this whole system, which is really a part of a warm front moving across our area, has been a bit on the active side over the course of the past few hours. So as this warm front makes its way through, some hot, humid air is going to come in for the next couple of days, and that'll keep our thunderstorm chances going. But right now, only one particular cell has got the attention of the National Weather Service. It's this one in the northern part of Prince George's County, where that warning goes until 5:45. I think that is the only warning in our region right now. Yep, that is it. That's the only strong storm right now that we have to be concerned with in that location. And we'll see if they continue the warning once it continues tracking south and east. And if it shows the signs of weakening, then maybe they'll cancel that. But for now, a warning is in effect for Prince George's County and the western part of Anne Arundel County until 5:45. Now the National Weather Service has said a confirmed tornado was located over Bowie, moving southeast at 25. So apparently somebody did see this one and confirmed that a tornado was there. Not sure if we've had any damage with it reported yet, but it was issued as far as a confirmed tornado. Somebody spotted something near Bowie as the storm is moving south and east. So be on the lookout for sure in that location. Other than that, we just have scattered rain showers moving across the upper eastern shore. And here in Baltimore, the rain has actually tapered off. And it does look like the worst of this weather will stay to the southwest of Annapolis, but impact those areas south of Route 50 in parts of Anne Arundel County as the storm is moving southeast. And again, the National Weather Service indicated that somebody did see a funnel cloud or a tornado around the Bowie area as the storm is making its way down to the south and east. This is the general track of the storm. And you can see if you're in that general area there, the storm system moving south and east should be around Queen Anne at 5:44. And then down toward London Town by 5:52 and Selby on the Bay just before 6 o'clock. So tracking right across that southern part of Anne Arundel County, potential for tornadic indications, tornadic weather there that you want to take seriously, because again, if somebody spotted it, it's more than just the radar seeing something. It's more of an actual observer reporting that they saw this system there. So safety tips are once again away from windows, interior part of your room, lowest level of the building that you're in. If you're caught outside, it's the worst place to be. You try to get to a sturdy shelter immediately. If you're driving, don't try to outrace it. If there's a low-lying area or a building nearby, you can get out of your car and get to that. But otherwise, you just buckle up and you stay inside that car and hope that the system does not track in your direction. It's a pretty small storm, so only a small area will be impacted by this system as it's moving across the Anne Arundel PG County line. There's the rainfall is pretty intense right now around Bowie and around Route 50 and 301. And wind speeds that we've been detecting have not been severe, but enough to do some damage there with that system. There's the potential storm system. So again, using Stirling's radar, these red winds are moving away, these red colors, and the greens are moving toward the radar site. So we would put that storm system somewhere in that general vicinity right now in the area of Bowie, south of Bowie, and crossing Route 50 and moving down in the direction of Queen Anne. So this is the direction of the storm system's moving, and it'll be moving at about 25 to 30 miles an hour. So take shelter right now in those locations. Very small part of this large area of unsettled weather, but a dangerous part of it for sure. moving down to the south and east. I don't know, guys, if we had any reports of anything come into the newsroom at all. Nobody seeing nothing. I don't know if we have any traffic cameras down there around Bowie that we could maybe take a look at on Route 50. Any traffic cameras that we could see? We could see this, the impact of this storm as it's crossing Route 50 in Prince George's County and heading south and east. And the warning going until 5:45. Let me see with the National Weather Service if they've updated anything on this warning. Right now they're just continuing it. The whole system has strong winds associated with it and a confirmed tornado located over Bowie. That was at 5:28 when they noticed the tornado in the Bowie area. But no further updates from that right now. So let me see the radar. There you go. There's the okay, let's take a look at that. Don, director, telling me we have some cameras out of Millersville where you just see the heavy rain is north of this storm system. That's I-97 north of the area there. But again, yeah, that would be just north of this powerful storm system where the rain may be letting up in that location right now. And the line that's generating this activity stretches right across the northern part of Anne Arundel County, and the storm system is moving south and east where we're concerned with possible tornado. And again, it's not always that you get reports, ground reports of what the radar is indicating, but apparently the National Weather Service got some reports that this, in fact, does have some tornadic activity with it. So be very careful. South of Bowie toward Queen Anne, western part of Anne Arundel County, this entire region right in here should be on the lookout for possible tornadic activity right now. The warning goes until 5:45, so another 10 minutes or so to see if this system holds together and continues to make its way down into Anne Arundel County. Haven't heard any other indications of anything additional information other than the National Weather Service initially issuing this. And so we like to monitor it and see what they do with it. But I'll leave it up to the director to produce if you want to go back to news coverage and we'll monitor this, or if you want to just wait this out. You got to let me know. All right. Okie doke. All right. Well, if we can get some more cameras that we can take a look at, because radar right now is just showing us that the area of rain, and I'm not sure how much information that's going to give you here in the next couple of minutes, other than again, it's definitely showing, you know, the rotation there, but nothing that looks, you know, there's Dover's, it looks pretty good as far as indicating conditions that are happening, with the red moving away and the green moving toward the radar from the Dover site. So this gives us an indication that in this location right in here, you might have a funnel cloud or a tornado. Funnel cloud is just a tornado that's not touching the ground. I would think, based on this activity, that the worst of the weather has passed Bowie and is now moving down closer to Queen Anne. So that staying still in PG County, the way it's looking right now, almost see two possible areas here, one in this location here and one in this location here, but this whole broad area from Bowie to Queen Anne is where the potential tornado warning is in effect. So this is where the warning goes until 5:45. The larger orange shaded area is just severe thunderstorm. So wind gusts to 60 miles an hour with this broad area of showers and storms. And then the concentrated red area here is where the potential funnel cloud or tornado is, in the general vicinity of or between Bowie and Queen Anne. So you can see Route 301 and then Route 50 here, and it looks like it would be in this general area. If we have a tornado on the ground, that would be the prime spot, the suspected spot that it would be. The Sterling radar is starting to break up a little bit and not look as good. Was hoping we could get something out of BWI, but this is not a whole lot of data showing up there from the BWI radar site. Let me see if Andrews Air Force Base, if their radar site would give us anything. This is from Andrews, Joint Base Andrews, definitely showing something there. As we can see, the gate-to-gate shear that we look for, the reds and the greens, if you will, coming together, and definitely this would be winds going this way and winds going this way, and it looks like, based on the Andrews Air Force Base radar returns, that we'd have something sitting about right in there. It would be the potential for possible tornado just to the east of 301 and just to the south of Route 50, east of 301, moving in the direction of Queen Anne. So that's definitely something that you'd want to watch out for. But so far, it's staying out of Anne Arundel County, it looks like, unless it's going to jump in this direction and move slowly over toward the far western part of Anne Arundel County. Any more cameras that you can look at, Don? Well, we could look at it anyway and see what it looks like. Do you have 301 or 214 or anything down there? Millersville is the closest we've got to our possible to a camera. Okay, that's just shows. Looks like again, it looks like the sun might be coming out up there in Millersville as the storm makes its way farther to the south and east. Yeah, let's see what it looks like in Annapolis. They're probably going to just about ready to get some pretty good rain. The mast on that sailboat going back and forth, but they're on the weaker side of the storm. They're going to get some heavy rain in Annapolis, but the possible tornado is sitting southwest of them by about. Let's see if we can measure how far southwest the actual, maybe about 10 miles, 11 miles southwest of Annapolis is where the tornadic thunderstorm is right now. So there's the warning location, moving southeast 25, 30 miles an hour. Radar indicated, but also spotted and observed so that the National Weather Service could confirm it. And they have not updated anything yet, so we'll see what happens here in the next few minutes, whether they keep it going or not. And we'll ask if you have any reports, and you can send them in to us. Once the storm has passed by, if you see any damage, give us a call, notify us on social media. I'm at TTassel, WBAL. You can send me a report or a picture there, and we'll pass it on. But wait until the storm system goes by for sure. You do not want to go out and take a look at it while it's moving through your area. You want to be in the middle of your house, the lowest level, under stairs, in a bathroom. Those tend to be the safest locations in a house. And ideally, you'd be down underground in the basement. That tends to be the safest location in a tornado warning, which is what we have right now. So away from windows, innermost, say, bathroom, basement, under the stairs, cover your head. You can almost always hear these storms as they go through, so people tend to wait for the sound of the storm to go by, and then they know the all clear is there, or when we tell you that the warning has been dropped. This is, it looks like it's evolving into a pretty good rainmaker there in western parts of Anne Arundel County, and it looks like whatever was in the buoy area has now passed through there and is continuing to track south and east down south of Route 50 now. 50 south of Crofton. Okay, so that's an interesting location there. Looks like heavy rain. Is that? I can almost try to see if I can see any hail associated with that. Doesn't look like it. But traffic certainly slowing down, so the rain must be significant there. It's 50 at Maryland 424. Okay, so that's not too far away. That would be just to the east of where this thing would be. So 50 at 424 would be right around here is where that camera was. And our possible tornado is sitting there just to the southwest of that location. Don't know what direction that was looking, but only about 3 miles away would be this tornadic thunderstorm from that camera that we were looking at. And so that was a pretty close one. That gets us a little closer to what it actually looks like. And definitely heavy rain. That red on that map right you're looking at right now is intense rainfall for sure. Yeah, I'll see if there's any potential hail. It's not indicating hail associated with this. The echo tops are not all that high, and the tallest of the storm is being blown off to the south and east. So the tornado is developing just to the southwest of the tallest part of this storm. It goes up now to 40,000 feet, and the velocity is definitely hot there. You can see that definite hot spot on our radar. This is out of Sterling, Virginia, with winds blowing this way and winds blowing this way. So sitting pretty close to Queen Anne now, I would think. It looks like if you're in that area, you definitely want to be taking shelter and being on the lowest level of your building for sure in the Queen Anne area. And then areas moving into the southern part of Anne Arundel County, the southwest part of Anne Arundel County for sure. Let's see what the storm tracks will show us here. It's lagging a little farther behind. That's sort of where it developed. And now it looks like it's moving more in the across the Anne Arundel PG County line. and making its way south and east, with the warning set to expire at 5:45. Another minute or so, we'll see if the Weather Service gets any additional reports and whether or not they want to keep it going or if they're going to cancel this system. Right now, they're just issuing marine warnings as the storm is going to be heading out across the bay. So certainly that would not be a good place to be out over the bay when a tornadic thunderstorm is moving in your direction. But it's very difficult to find a safe place when you're out over the bay. So get to shore quickly, anybody who's out over the bay right now with this line of storms moving through. Even if it's not tornadic, it's going to have gusty winds associated with it as well. Let's take another look at that Route 50 in Crofton area camera if we can, Don. Yeah, there you go. There's some. So that's US 50 West, US 50 at Rutland Road. Is that a different one or is that the same? Just east a little more. Do you have the other one? The one that was at 424, 50 and 424? Because that's pretty close to some pretty intense activity right now. So I would think that, yeah, we're looking at potential. Okay, so there you go, 50 east, yeah, at 424. That's not far from the center of this strong storm. All we can see there is obviously slow traffic, so heavy rain ahead for sure. Definitely slowing traffic down. The brightest echoes, two of them now, really. It's interesting to see them divided that way into two different parts on our radar, where we have this strong shear here and then one up here. So whether or not there are two separate possible tornadoes, it's hard to tell, but definitely something going on in that area of western Anne Arundel County for sure. A little disorganized, not clear cut, but dangerous enough for the warning to now be extended until 6:30. So for this area to go all the way across the southern part of Anne Arundel County, that's a large chunk of Anne Arundel County. But again, it's south of Annapolis and moving in the direction of Shadyside. So coming across the PG Anne Arundel County line now and moving down to the south and east, that's a large swath of Anne Arundel County that needs to be prepared for possible tornadic thunderstorm moving in from the northwest. Again, the system is moving northwest to southeast at about 25 to 30 miles an hour. So everybody up around Queen Anne would be taking shelter now, and then you'd be preparing for a possible tornadic system to move in your direction to the south and east of there, which would include everybody, you know, along Route 2 there, south of 214. And the entire region there of southwestern Anne Arundel County should be taking shelter. Marriott Hill, Queen Anne, Bayard, everybody near Route 2, south of 214. This region is going to be impacted by a very strong thunderstorm, if not a possible tornado in the area. That's some pretty bright returns for us there. Let's see what the wind speeds are up there aloft the Dulles Airport, picking up some strong winds just above the surface there. So if that mixes down, you get some dangerous wind damage, even if you're not near that. The system just leaped pretty good there over toward Marriott Hill. So be on the lookout here in the southern part of Anne Arundel County. A thunderstorm that may have a tornado is moving through your area as we speak, and potential to do some damage as it makes its way through the Marriott Hill area there down across Anne Arundel County. So let's see if we can get some storm tracks on here. Right now just showing strong rotation and not indicating any tornadic activity, at least based on this algorithm. But anytime you see that kind of strong rotation, you do want to be advised that it may well have a tornado associated with it. So take shelter in southern Anne Arundel County. We've got warnings out for you until 6:30 this evening. That is a long stretch to issue that kind of a tornado warning there, and severe activity out across the bay as well. So you want to know your tornado safety tips and get to the lowest level of your building until that system can go out. I'll see what the Weather Service has said here. Just about the time the warning was about to expire at 5:44, they were still saying it was capable of producing a tornado near Londontown or Bowie, moving southeast at 25. But no, received a report from a spotter that saw the funnel cloud near Bowie halfway to the ground. So when they said the tornado was confirmed, it was really a funnel cloud halfway to the ground when it was up near the buoy area, with the potential of touching down and doing damage as it moved to the south and east. So all of southern Anne Arundel County is under that warning until 6:30 this evening. Hey, let me check other locations here to see if we can monitor the progress of this storm as it moves south and see if we've had any reports from anybody seeing any additional damage or anything. I'll check my Twitter account again. I'm at @TTassel WBAL. If you have any kind of reports that you want to send into us, we'd be happy to hear them. But again, we encourage you to wait until the system is out of your neighborhood. And then if you see any raining much heavier around 50, you want to show that camera, Don, to see what we've got there? Let's see. 3D view, not getting any reports of damage.
Well,
let's see.
All right, Tom, well, I was just going to jump in and say the same thing, that Andre and I have been looking to see if there are any reports of damage in the buoy area or heading southeast, and we have not seen anything just yet. I'm curious, when you say, so what you're seeing is that there's activity and you're seeing the, excuse my ignorance on the word, the funnel.
Yeah.
But at this point, when we say what's been confirmed so far, not that a tornado has touched down.
Correct. Yeah. Yeah, the Weather Service initially confirmed that somebody had spotted it, but what they spotted was the funnel cloud halfway down from the base of the cloud to the ground. So, I mean, sometimes you don't see the actual funnel hitting the ground until it starts to kick up enough debris, you know, where you can see it. But apparently the report came in that it was a funnel cloud trying to touch down. And that was when it was up near Bowie. So that's a little while back. It may have touched down. It may have gone back up. Sometimes these things skip. They're on the ground for a short period of time, and then they move up again and skip down the road and then touch down again. So it's tornadic. The thunderstorm that we're seeing here is very capable of producing a damaging tornado, is sort of what that indicates.
Considering the speed that you're seeing, does this, the 6:30, does that make sense to you in terms of what's
that
southeast,
seems like a long stretch.
County?
Yeah, I think it'll be out of the county by then, probably out over the bay by then. Which is another warning, if you know anybody out there and you can get in touch with them, anybody listening to us or on radio or whatever out over the bay, you'd want to take shelter now as that storm is going to move offshore near Shadyside and then move out over the bay.
So, Tom, just to follow up to what you were talking about with Kai, the warning was extended to 6:30. Is that because of the potential for that funnel cloud to perhaps touch the ground and then become a full-fledged tornado?
Yeah, I think that's exactly right, Andre. Yeah, it's not that the storm will be on the ground for an hour and a half or whatever, but that the same system that produced the funnel cloud and maybe a tornado near Bowie is moving now through southern Anne Arundel County, and another funnel cloud or tornado could drop down from the same system. Typically, when they have the capability or when they're forming these funnel clouds, they will continue to do so, at least as they track along their path. So even if it's not on the ground for that entire time, you do want to be on the lookout for a possible tornado in that area. And this is where our warning covers a huge area there across all of southern Anne Arundel County, including areas like Marriott Hill, eventually over to Shadyside. And I think the main track that we would be concerned with here would be from Queen Anne, generally speaking, over to Marriott Hill and down toward Shadyside. So they give it some leeway on either side of that, but that would, I think, would be the favored track for this potential tornado in that area there. And we'll widen it up here and see the storm. Again, it started up near the buoy area and has been moving south and east at about 25 miles an hour, 25 to 30 almost miles an hour is the way it's moving. So. Yeah, and again, anybody from Davidsonville south to Route 2 should be taking shelter right now. Londontown, probably on the northern edge of this damaging wind area, and then eventually down a little farther south towards Shadyside. So that whole general area should be looking out for potential severe weather, if not a tornado, this entire region here in Anne Arundel County. Well to the south of Annapolis, but definitely impacting that southern part of Anne Arundel County. And again, you can contact us through social media if you see damage after the storm passes by. We'd like to know if there's any damage associated with it for sure, but not until you're in a safe enough condition to get outside and take a look and see what's going on. Safety tips, you probably know them by heart right now. You know, you get in the middle of your house, lowest level. and away from windows. Those seem to be the best things that you can do to protect yourself. And if you hear it in your area, you cover your head with a pillow or a mattress, something like that, so that you're protected from any kind of falling or possible debris in the area. I see that Greg Ng, our tech guy here and our web guy, might have seen some video. Let me see, what is he talking about? The sun is out in Howard County, somebody's saying. Bowie Bay Sox game, somebody's worried about. I think that's going to be all right because the storm will pass through the Bowie area and you probably get some clearing. Getting some reports of very heavy rain in Edgewater. So you definitely want to be on the lookout for that. And let's see, what is Greg talking about? I'm trying to check my social media here to see what we've got. We had a report. Did you get a report there, Kai? Was it? Oh, that, where is that from? From the Bowie area?
Bowie area.
I don't see the funnel cloud there, but definitely looks like a severe thunderstorm, no doubt about that.
Looks scary.
Yeah,
it is.
Yeah. Meg Handtruck contacted us with it, and Greg Ng has forwarded this with showing rotation and airborne debris associated with the storm as it moved through the Bowie area again. Between Annapolis Road, between 197 and Route 3. That does look like some rotation there, but not a real distinct and obvious tornado. But, you know, I mean, they can be obscured by rain. They can be obscured by trees in your area. And around here, sometimes it's hard to get a really clear view of tornadoes. It's not like being out in the Plain States where you got miles and miles of visibility and you can see them in the distance. This area, though, is still under the tornado warning until 6:30. South of Route 50, along Route 2, moving down toward Marriott Hill, over toward Shadyside, south of Londontown, prime area here for a possible tornado. The radar has been showing us the storm, and this is the one right here that it's possibly producing the tornado. You can kind of see it in that location. And the Doppler velocity showing us the very distinct, really strong gate-to-gate signature there now. This is out of Sterling, Virginia. So just to remind you, the winds blowing toward the radar site here and away here. So somewhere south of Mill Swamp and to the west of Shadyside, a possible tornado right now. That's a pretty strong signature showing up on radar as we speak. So that location looks like it may well have something going on there. And that would be in the vicinity of 468 near Cumberstone, west of Shadyside. In the Cumberstone area there, along 468, east of Route 2 now. Looks like it's past Route 2, and this would be the area that would be of most concern, this location right in here, using Sterling's radar. This could be up aloft again, because the radar is located in Northern Virginia, and the radar beam tilts upward, and so you're going to get some elevation here with them, and the radar is hitting this storm in this location, but it definitely looks like you got some rotation there. Weakened a little bit there on the latest sweep, not quite as bright and strong as it was in the past one, but definitely something, and even another one possible. I mean, it's possible that you could have two separate areas of rotation, one here north of Mill Swamp, the other one, stronger one, just to the west of Shadyside. So those locations do need to be monitored. Here's the Dover, and it shows the same location, and then the Sterling, Virginia one showing the same basic location. Unfortunately, nothing coming out of BWI, that's Phillies, yep, all showing about the same. Let me see if I can get back over toward the Joint Base Andrews to see what their radar looks like.
Tom, as you're doing that, if I could, since we're starting to see more people post pictures and their thoughts on what they're seeing, I guess we could maybe give a little bit of a lesson here. When we see wall cloud, I'm seeing that quite often in a lot of people's posts. What exactly does that mean?
That's just sort of the initial dropping down of the tornado forming. So you have the thunderstorm cell, and then you have sort of a wall cloud that begins to drop, and then that wall cloud begins to rotate, and then a funnel drops down from there. So that would be the infant or embryonic stages of this beginning tornado that you might see if they see that. And again, this warning covers this area here, all along Route 468 east. And again, the warning now, I think, would be primarily concentrated from 468 heading over to Shadyside. Storm is going to move through rather quickly. and then move out over the bay in short order. So you can see the heavy rain extends up almost to London Town, but the main area of concern as far as a possible tornado would be in this location here, east of 468, heading over to Shadyside. See if we can find any other communities there that would be impacted there. South River, Mayo, Shadyside, Cumberstone, all these locations should be monitoring the storm very closely for potential tornado in your area. The warning covers a large area, but the tornado would be in a small particular location. What you got there, Kai? That's another picture coming in. Do you know where that's from?
Buoy, it says.
The buoy area? Yeah. So, see, the storm has cleared the buoy area, so it's safe to send those things now. They may be looking south of it. They may also be looking south to see the storm moving away from buoy, because it was up there a few minutes ago and is now out of that location and would be more. Yes, Andre.
Tracking this system, some viewers are tracking our coverage and watching you on social media. Mm-hmm. You have a question. Woman is asking, they're about to go over the Bay Bridge. A general question.
Okay.
Is it safe to do that right now on Facebook?
Yes, I think the Bay Bridge. So here we are up here at the Bay Bridge. You got some heavy rain, you got some showers around. You might see some lightning off in the distance or so, but right now it's mostly just rain in the Bay Bridge area. So here's the Bay Bridge coming across over to Stevensville. And there's rain. I mean, there's rain. It's not going to be the most pleasant trip across the Bay Bridge, but it's not at risk of a tornado in that area. It's mostly just showery weather. And again, if we widen the view here, you'll notice once this gets out of the way, this line of storms really stretching here, once it goes past us, then it's going to really quiet down pretty nicely. In fact, here in Baltimore, the rain has stopped. And even in Bowie, where we saw the original storm popping up, it's not nearly as dangerous right now in that location. The danger area is down here, just to the southwest of Mayo, northwest of Shadyside, in this particular part of Anne Arundel County, where we've got very heavy rain coming down, and we've got strong wind shear indicated. It looks like it's getting close to Shadyside now. So very dangerous situation there, south of Mayo, north of Shadyside. Be taking shelter now. It's all east of Route 468. This is 468, and it looks like there's a potential strong rotation here. Okay, just about ready to go out over the bay. Cockeysville, okay, this would not be associated with this particular storm, but there's another system, another thunderstorm in the area of Cockeysville that did some tree damage, it looks like, for sure. Definitely got some tree damage there. Yeah, not sure what would have caused that. Can't see it exactly if that was chopped off or just bent over from a storm system. That's farther north in Baltimore County. This one in Anne Arundel County here is the one that may have a tornado associated with it. So it's getting pretty close to the shore of the bay, and mariners are going to have to be on the lookout here, because here's the motion in the past hour. Let me slow it down so we can get a better look at how it's moving. And there you see it coming in from PG County, right across Anne Arundel County, and now almost to the bay near Shadyside is where this storm system is right now. So let me just, so you notice it comes through the Queen Anne area, starts up in Bowie, then drops south and east through western Anne Arundel, organizes, and it looks like it's moving over just to the northwest of Shadyside now and about ready to come across the bay. So a very interesting storm over the course of the past 30 to 45 minutes or so, been making its way right across that Anne Arundel County. It'll be interesting to see if we get any other reports from Queen Anne's across Route 2, Route 468, and now in the Shadyside area. But if you're in Shadyside or that area of eastern Anne Arundel County, south of Mayo, north of Shadyside, near the bay, you want to be taking shelter and be on the lookout for possible damage. You want to make sure that system gets past you now, because it's definitely distinct. What do you say, Deb?
I was just going to report that BGE tells us now that a little over 1,000 customers are without power at this moment. And let's just do a little reset here, too, mm-hmm. if we can, Tom, mm-hmm. since we have moved into our 6 o'clock hour. Just a reset at the top on what is going on right now and what warning is currently in place. Anne Arundel County, we have a tornado warning until 6:30. Is that correct, Tom?
Yes, 6:30. Let me show you what you got here. So
okay.
You got there's the warning area until 6:30. Thunderstorm warning, it really just kind of goes along with the storm that's producing the tornado. There's no sense in having that as well. It's a tornadic thunderstorm that covers this large area of Anne Arundel County. It's right now south of Mayo, north of Shadyside, the main threat area here for a possible tornado. And see, they've just... They've just narrowed it even further. It looks like it's about to move over the bay. So notice how the tornado warning has shrunk down to this area south of Mayo, north of Shadyside. I think mainly in the Shadyside area here, moving out over the bay as we speak. So these areas need to be very careful. I think you have most likely a tornado in that thunderstorm right there, just to the northwest of Shadyside in this location, moving out over the bay. And it is going to clear the coast there, and then we'll see what happens as it tracks across the bay. But a very dangerous situation for any boaters or recreational boaters or commercial fishermen. Ships out on the bay need to be on the lookout for this. It's a very dangerous situation right now with this well-defined shear couplet here, 77-mile-an-hour gate shear, 50-mile-an-hour wind speeds. That's a pretty good storm system that's been located and identified by radar moving out across the bay. Again, this is the motion of it over the past few minutes, moving northwest to southeast as it crosses the Shadyside area and just about over the bay. So that the National Weather Service keeps that warning going until 6:30, but we'll see what they do once it gets out over the open waters. It'll most likely become a marine warning or a water spout for this possible tornado in that area.
I'll tell you, Tom, when we came in today, I mean, the humidity level was certainly foreboding. I mean, you could really feel it in the air. And I know that you have been predicting for the rest of the week that we have really a volatile weather pattern that we're in over the next couple of days.
We do. This is all associated with a warm front that's bringing that warm, steamy summer air in. And any little weather disturbance that tracks through this kind of warm, muggy air can touch off these strong storms, especially along the warm front. I think this is what's helping these get this spin going here. The frontal boundary itself kind of adds some twist to the atmosphere, and so you get these quick spin-up tornadoes that we're seeing in on radar this evening. So that's the radar scene right there. From radar, it just looks like heavy rain, but then when you dig in deeper and you look at the winds in there, you definitely see some strong turning of the winds in this location. So weather system that looks like it's now maybe even dipping down to the south of the Shadyside area, but anywhere from this Franklin Manor on the bay up to Shadyside, this location is definitely being impacted by a severe thunderstorm that could have a tornado with it for sure.
If you are in Shadyside, if you're in this area, we want to put our graphic up to remind people what to do in a situation like this. You want to seek shelter. You obviously want to stay away from the windows, as tempting as it may be to see what's going on outside. That's the last place you want to be. You want to go to the lowest level of a sturdy building, the innermost room, and away from windows. And if you do not live in this area, but if you know someone who is in this area, please let them know what is going on and to seek shelter and seek a safe room in their home. Tom.
Hey, Deb, we've got Tony Pan on the phone here. He was in earlier this afternoon. Looked like we had the all clear, didn't it, Tony? And then this one popped up.
It did. That's what's so interesting to me. You know, for years, you and I have talked about if Maryland has a tornado alley, it would be right in that area, Prince George's County, Anne Arundel County, and right there. And for a long time, you know, we've been discussing, well, why is that? And I think today was like the perfect example of how that happens. The bay breeze interacting with a warm front creates that spin on the tail end of these storms. Now, that line of storms came out of Pennsylvania, and you notice that this developed right on the tail end of that line. And I really think that's what it is. I really think the bay breeze enhances the low-level spin in that area. And I've often said, if you check the wind direction at BWI, before these storms come in, if it's southeast, that's an indication that you're going to wind up with some severe weather and the possibility of tornadoes. If the wind direction at BWI is south or southwest, then it doesn't seem to happen. But if it's east or southeast, then these things spin up. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I think that makes some sense. I mean, we've had this warm front moving through, and like you say, that southeast wind or that bay breeze feeding into that warm front as it's lifting through, it's going to give you some shear, and that's what we're seeing here with this system for sure. And like you say, that area from south of us down through southern Maryland, definitely our tornado alley in Maryland for sure. And we've got, you know, you've had the numerous La Plata storms down in Charles County, and all these systems that kind of fire up as they're going there, definitely complicated by the bay, as almost all of our weather is around here. Complicated by the bay. For sure.
And so what Tom, Tom's talking about is how the wind direction changes with height. So if you have, let's say, at the surface, the bay breeze creates a southeast wind. But aloft, you can notice the storm motion is from the northwest to the southeast. Aloft, the winds are coming from a completely different direction, from the northwest to the southeast, and that's what creates the spin in the storm and eventually creates a tornado or a waterspout.
Yep, and so it looks like right now, Tony, it's pretty close to Shadyside. They're probably almost out over the bay. We did have some damage reports up your way, up into Baltimore County. Did you see any damage on your way back or in the past hour or so?
No, but we picked up some heavy downpours up here, close to a half inch of rain in about a half an hour, but no strong winds or damage that I saw up in Baltimore County.
Okay.
But I've been seeing a lot of stuff online. I think it was Kai that mentioned people were saying they saw the wall cloud with this storm, and you certainly could see it approaching, and people have been sending me pictures of that descending wall cloud. It's like the part of the storm that is about to create the tornado starts to drop out of the bottom of the base of the the thundercloud, and that's what the quote-unquote wall cloud is. And a lot of people mistake that with a shelf cloud. A shelf cloud is longer. It kind of looks like one of those alien ships. You know, you've seen those pictures.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly. But a wall cloud is a very small, defined piece of cloud that drops down out of the bottom of the storm. And a lot of people were seeing that. And when you see that, that's a really good indication that the storm, the updraft in the storm is starting to rotate, and something probably is going to develop when you see that.
Yep, it looks like it's, I'm almost sure now, it's almost just about ready to go out over the bay where we're getting the strongest shear. So we're going to see if the Weather Service is going to transition this into something other than a tornado warning for that location. They're continuing it at 6:06. They continued it for Anne Arundel for a confirmed tornado located over Shadyside, moving southeast at 25, so that's pretty much where we've had it. So it should be, even as we speak, probably getting out over the waters, and I don't know if anybody's going to see it out there from the shore, or if it'll be a waterspout out over the bay.
Probably,
Yeah, most likely. So waterspouts are just tornadoes over water, and it's a very dangerous situation for folks who are doing any kind of boating or just enjoying the bay this evening. It's going to be very dangerous as this system crosses.
There's that... There's that mythology that, you know, water sprouts aren't as dangerous as tornadoes. And and you hit it right on the head. Yeah. A water spout is just a tornado over the water.
Right, right.
And when it comes on shore, it's going to do the same thing. So if you're listening to us or watching us over around St. Michael's across the bay, this will probably head over towards, at least towards St. Michael's in that area.
Yeah, probably if it holds together. Yeah, the water temperatures are going to be a little cooler, so it may take a little oomph out of it, you know, because it's...
Oh, that's true,
I mean, but it could, but it's the same system, so it gets back over land over there in Talbot County. You got to be on the lookout, see if it regenerates over there in the warm, muggy air that we've had. The dew point over in Easton this afternoon was 79. So, I mean...
Oh, man,
it's very tropical. Yes.
Can I ask you a question? Actually, Tony. Tony, can you hear me?
I can hear you,
So I want to follow up on what you were telling Tom earlier. You were talking about the south and southeast winds at BWI. You obviously said that. I mean, did you observe south and southeast winds at BWI today? And is that the kind of information that we could use in the future to warn people down in the Anne Arundel County area that when we have a day like this, when we're expecting severe thunderstorms, and we have south and southeast winds at BWI, is this something that we can kind of get ahead of?
It's just, it's an indicator that that I look at, and Tom, you know, because we've been forecasting around here for a really long time. So you start to notice little nuances like that in a severe weather situation. And yes, if, let's say, the Storm Prediction Center has us in the outlooked area for the possibility of severe weather like they did today, and when the storms are approaching, if you see a southeast wind at BWI, that sends out an alert. It says, hey, man, some of these storms may start to rotate, but it's not a specific thing that you would say every single time I see the southeast wind, it's going to make a tornado. So you really couldn't make that kind of a connection, but it's certainly an indication of the possibility of something like this happening.
Yep. So there you go. There's the motion of it from Shadyside out over the bay. Watch out, as Tony was mentioning, in the general direction of St. Michael's. If it holds together and redevelops, it could clip that area over there into Talbot County over on the eastern shore. So you can definitely see the hot spot for sure. It's pretty easy to identify here. But notice it's beginning to elongate, fall apart, get a little less distinct. So maybe the cooler waters of the bay will take some of the punch out of this storm, at least for a while, until it can cross back over north of Tillman and then move over maybe toward Easton or St. Michael's over on the eastern shore. For now, the Weather Service still has that warning going until 6:30. Let's see if they have canceled it. They have not.
Are you in the chat over there?
Yeah, I'm looking at the chat. Yep, and Weather Service has not given any additional other than confirmed tornado near Shadyside moving southeast. And the
Confirmed tornado, did they?
Yeah, because they had some reports come in of funnel clouds. They had a funnel cloud up near Bowie that was halfway down.
Oh, somebody saw it. Okay,
yeah. So they did confirm it when it was up that way, but it since has made that progress down across a large chunk of Anne Arundel County, and I'm wondering if anybody else has seen it. You got a large following there, Tony. Any of your followers reporting any videos or damage down there in southern Anne Arundel County?
Other than the wall cloud pictures, I have not seen, but if anybody's listening and you want to send me a picture or, well, hopefully you weren't outside taking pictures, but if you saw the funnel cloud or you have witnessed tornado on the ground, let me know and I'll pass it along to our newsroom for sure.
What's your Twitter handle there, Tony?
Tony Pan, and Tony Pan, WBAL.
Yep.
And you can send it to me and I'll pass it along, or you can send it to Tom. Tom's already at work there. And... you know, I'm switching through right now. I don't see any videos or other than the wall cloud thing. I haven't seen anybody post. Although there's somebody from Bowie that sent a video to me. If you want to scroll through my line, somebody tagged me on it. As the storm went through Bowie, you can actually see the rotation.
Yeah, I think
that
Greg
might
Ng
be
had
the funnel cloud.
Yeah. I think Greg Ng sent that to us too. I think that might be the one you're looking at. Yeah. Andre, what's your Twitter handle, Andre?
Andre Hepkins, at Andre Hepkins.
At Andre Hepkins, WBAL. Deb Wiener?
Yes.
You're on Twitter, yeah.
Yes,
any, you
for
send
sure.
it to any of us. We'll get the pictures and we'll see what's going on down there in the Shadyside area. But again, it does look like this storm, if it has a tornado, is now out over the bay. So this would be the area right here. It's pretty much east of Shadyside, out over the bay. It would be interesting. Anybody watching us or hearing us down in Shadyside, if you had any damage with this system that moved through, anybody along north of Lothian, along Route 2, Route 468, and then Shadyside, Queen Anne, Bowie, that whole track area there looks like the area that was impacted by this storm from Queen Anne to Shadyside, right across Anne Arundel County and now out over the bay. So hopefully no damage, hopefully no injuries from this system, but definitely a distinct storm that is now moving across the Chesapeake for sure.
That's
the other thing, you know, Tom just mentioned there, if you're... you know, trying to be an amateur meteorologist at home or whatever, when you see these kinds of storms break off on their own from the tail end of a line of storms, like Tom would, I'm sure he could zoom out and show you the line that went through, it's very often that storm right at the tail end of the line that starts to spin like that. And if it breaks off on its own, especially like this one does, you can see it's detached from the main line that's up towards Centerville and Queenstown over on the eastern shore. Those are the ones you have to watch. But it's also a good indication, like Tom said, the storm looks a little more elongated from the northwest to the southeast. And that might be an indication that it's weakened a little bit. But it's over the water now, so we'll see.
Yeah, and folks over on the eastern shore should take note that this has been a tornadic storm. So you and Tillman, St. Michael's, those areas over there in northern Talbot County, Easton even, be on the lookout. You go with the history of the storm. If it's had a history of producing funnel clouds, possible tornadoes, you know when it gets in your neighborhood, it could do the same thing. So I just heard a bell go off. Let me check our chat here and see if we've got any updates on the warnings.
While you do that, I'm going to talk for a second. This is also a good lesson for everybody in that there doesn't necessarily have to be a severe thunderstorm watch in effect or a tornado watch in effect to have these kinds of things happen. Sometimes the atmosphere is just right, and Mother Nature doesn't care if there's a tornado watch in effect or a severe thunderstorm watch in effect. If the conditions are right for this to happen, it's going to happen. And obviously, this was a bit of a surprise, but it goes to show you that it can happen even if we're not in some sort of tornado watch or severe thunderstorm watch. What do you got, Tom?
So it's interesting. They were issuing it until 6:45, and then right after that, it looks like they have canceled the tornado rounding for Anne Arundel County. So the thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado near Deal, moving southeast 25.
Yeah, that's two different cells there. Yeah. You notice they let the one go because here's the weird thing about our weather service. They only cover the folks in Sterling, what happens on the western shore of the bay. When it crosses over the bay, that becomes the Weather Office of Philadelphia or Wakefield, Virginia.
Right.
So the warning for St. Michael's, or if it's going to be, would have to come from them. But Sterling looks like they just issued a warning for that cell that's just to the west or southwest of the one that's crossing the bay. Is that right? Near Lothian and Deal?
Deal, yeah, exactly, yeah, yeah.
So maybe that one, that's the one they think is rotating. There's two storms that could be rotating, and they're both distinct there, yeah.
Yeah, for sure, yeah, south of Shadyside down there toward Deal. For sure, they kept that one going. Let's see where the warnings go. They kept that one going until 6:45, so mm-hmm. That's the new one for a possible system in that location. Not as distinct for sure on our returns here as far as velocity goes, but apparently something that they're enough concerned with in this area. Most likely, probably sitting up in here. But really not as clear-cut as the Shadyside one, for sure.
It doesn't look like it, does it? It doesn't look like the rotation is as distinct or as defined.
Yeah, let me see what the
Andrews, one that's over the bay.
Maybe Andrews will pick that up down near...
Yeah, Andrews. Go to Andrews, right. See, yeah,
not a whole lot going on there either as far as distinct. That one, maybe just kind of... being careful because of the system that we've been dealing with.
Yeah, they probably just issued it out of an abundance of caution, perhaps.
That's what it looks like for sure, because there isn't a whole lot of rotation.
Maybe they got a report of something else too. Mm-hmm. I mean, somebody from down there may have seen, a funnel cloud or something. Yeah.
Yeah, they didn't.
Well, this is a more populated area too, gentlemen. It's like 10,000.
Yes, that's true.
Over 10,000 people in this particular area. Mm-hmm. Got four schools and. You know, a lot more. It's more populated than the area we were talking about just 20 minutes ago. So they're, you know, greater concern, I would imagine.
So something in this area here, south of Lothian, moving over toward Deal, and then the one over the bay, has definitely weakened a lot as it's made its way across the waters now. But again, could still have damaging winds heading over toward Talbot County, Tillman, St. Michael's, maybe eventually over to Easton. But this whole area here in the southern part, south of Shadyside down to Deal, southern part of Anne Arundel County, and then out over the bay is the area of concern right now. But the primary one, it looks like Philadelphia now is going to issue a tornado warning for parts of the eastern shore until 7 o'clock. So that one coming across the bay could well produce it. So it looks like they definitely are doing that. The one out over the bay moving toward Talbot County and Queen Anne's County, the southern part there of Kent Island, and then down toward Tillman Island, and then the one in southern Anne Arundel County. So you got two possible systems right now in the
Those
area.
Those two cells have really broken off and become distinct supercells. What's the, just out of curiosity, Tom, the echo top on the storm crossing the bay?
Yeah, wasn't
Is
that
it
impressive?
50,000 feet?
No, it was under 40,000, like 31,000 now.
Okay.
It was weird because in Anne Arundel County, it only got up to around 40,000, at least when I was checking it. And right now, it's definitely collapsed a little bit. It's not nearly as tall. So interesting in that regard that it didn't have really a tall storm, but did have distinct rotation. But so for people who are watching us now, we've got this cell here and this cell here. We've got two different cells that could have possible tornadoes associated with them. And the Weather Service has issued warnings that cover both of those. The one in Anne Arundel County until 6:45, and the one for parts of Queen Anne's and Talbot counties until 7 p.m. this evening. Again, we have multiple National Weather Service offices, as Tony was mentioning, that cover our area. Once it gets over the bay and onto the eastern shore, then the folks up in the Philly, National Weather Service in Philly, actually monitor our eastern shore. And the folks down in Sterling, Virginia, near Dulles Airport, monitor areas west of the bay. So
it's good that they're keeping the continuity going, because sometimes it gets a little disjointed, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
From one weather office to another when the storms cross the bay like that, at least they were obviously discussing what was going on, or at least watching what was going on with the storm when it came out of Anne Arundel County. Is the I'm looking at home here, but I can't see the TV. Mm-hmm. The warning that Philadelphia issued looks like it's like right on the shore. In other words, they didn't extend it too far inland.
No,
is that correct?
Yeah, I think they're anticipating, you know, kind of landfall of that thunderstorm that crossing the bay, and to see if any kind of waterspout comes on shore as a tornado. So yeah, it's not far inland at all. I want to see what they said when they issued their warning there. So they issued the tornado warning. Yeah, they said that Severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado located over Kent Point or Shadyside, moving east at 20. So it's the same system. Yeah, they probably were monitoring Sterling's information and talking to each other and keeping that warning going for that storm over there on the eastern shore and then the one on the western shore of the bay as well. Let's see what the radar returns. Yeah, that's pretty good.
The only good the only good thing about this, I guess, is that it's not what we classify as a supercell. I mean, it's not 50,000 feet tall.
Right, right.
So if there is a tornado or a water spout in there, it's most likely an EF 0 or 1. That doesn't mean it's not going to cause any damage, and I don't mean you shouldn't be heading to your safe place, because you most certainly should be. But that's one good thing, I guess.
Yep. So here's your general areas here, the two possible tornadoes that we're monitoring on radar right now. One that's bearing down on Deal. Definitely take shelter in that location, as this system is going to be tracking in the direction of Deal, coming across just to the west of you guys now, right now, maybe passing south of Sudley, northwest of Deal, as it makes its way toward the bay as well. And then the other one, which is just this big area that you can see here of general possible rotation out over the bay. This was the original one that started up near Bowie. It's now sitting out over the middle part of the bay as a waterspout, perhaps moving over toward the eastern shore. And I would say, based on the motion of that one, that you know, if you're over there in St. Michael's, you definitely want to be paying attention north of Tillman. It looks like the area that would be most prone for this one to come on shore would be in this area here, which stretches basically to the west of St. Michael's and then down toward Tillman. So this whole area here, the western shore or the eastern shore, would be on the lookout right around Route 33. So you can kind of see it, maybe even trying to reorganize here with some shear indicator right over the middle part of the bay and then one to the west of Deal. Two areas of concern. Want to reiterate the safety tips. I think everybody pretty much knows them now. Lowest level of your building, away from windows, basement if you have it, bathroom underneath the stairs, cover your head and wait for the sound of the storm to move on by. That's sort of the best way you can deal with these things. Let's see.
I just got on Tom, if you want to check out my Twitter feed, I got a picture of storm damage in Bowie. Looks like a really large tree knocked over and pulled up from its roots.
Wow. Okay. Okay.
So that's a big wind that did that. I don't see any other trees in this shot that look like they were sawed off or anything like that, but there was definitely a big wind that went through the Bowie area for sure.
I think we've got a picture of that damage there on the screen. Probably the same picture that you're looking at there, Tony. Let's see. I'm trying to read some of this stuff that came out of Anne Arundel County, Anne Arundel County's first alert. Unknown damage, unknown injuries, radar showed images. So they're just monitoring it, too. They haven't had any reports of anything yet.
Yeah, I mean, other than those two things, I have not seen too many people, like, writing in and saying, I got a couple more. People keep sending me the same picture from Bowie. That's good. Again, if you're in the path of this thing, we don't say go outside and take pictures of it. I don't want you to do that. But if you just happened to catch something, go ahead and send it to me.
A lot of times doorbell cameras will do it, you know?
Yeah, I'm going to retweet something here in just a moment that is from the Bowie area. If you're watching my Twitter feed, I'm gonna retweet it right now. That looks like the wall cloud and the rotation of that storm coming near Bowie when it was going through. That is, I'm watching the video now because I'm getting all these things sent to me. I'm watching the video now, and that kind of looks like the actual beginning of this storm and the wall cloud dropping and the funnel kind of reaching the ground. So if you want to look at this live with me, you can go to my Twitter feed. I just retweeted it, Tony Pan, WBAL, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. But, yeah, they're all starting to come in now, Tom. We don't want you to go outside and do this, unless you're safe. And if you have the pictures of any damage afterwards, after the storm passes, go ahead and send them to me. How are things looking with those two cells now, Tom? The one passing through Deal and the other one is heading just south of St. Michael's, it looks like?
Yeah, it looks like that's the one over the bay appears to be trying to reorganize a little bit. You're getting a little more distinct return on the shear. So I'd be definitely on the lookout there as it comes on shore north of Tillman to maybe just to the southwest of St. Michael's if it holds together. Course could jump around too, and then the one in Deal is definitely there as well, showing a little more significant return on that one. So definitely two cells that could have tornadoes associated with them showing up on radar, and that's why the National Weather Service has these warnings in effect for both of those locations. The one in Anne Arundel County is set to expire at 6:45, the one on the eastern shore at 7 p.m. So inland north of Tillman, south of St. Michael's, be on the lookout there as a system coming in off the bay is going to sweep in pretty quickly and maybe impact that part of Talbot County. I think it's going to stay south of Kent Island, probably south of Queen Anne's County, but definitely be on the lookout there in the western part of Talbot County.
Tom,
yes.
Take a look at that storm, because I can pull up radar here at home, as you guys know. The storm that is north of the one in Deal that's just west of Edgewater and right now between Bowie and Edgewater, is on our system, is that one showing rotation as well? Because it kind of looks like it.
North of
the
Deal?
Little one that just developed behind it.
Oh, the one behind it there? Yeah. Let's take a look here. Let's see what we've got. It does have a little, it may have a potential trying to get something organized.
Yeah,
there.
This is a very strange situation here. These storms seem to be like backfilling or developing on the back side of each other. And
maybe a bay breeze.
You guys might want to watch that one because that's heading down towards Shadyside as well. It's just to the west of Edgewater in between Bowie and Edgewater. That one might have some potential.
Yeah.
Do you think?
Yeah, potentially for sure. Don is just telling, or our director here is just telling me that we had some video of possible tornadoes in the Bowie area. Go ahead, Deb.
Yes, we have some video that was just sent in to us. We want to take a look at it now. This is new video from Michael Carroll. Michael, thank you for sending this in to us. He took this in Bowie. This was about 5:30 earlier this evening, so this was just about an hour ago. Michael Carroll, a resident of that area, took this video in Bowie. We also have some additional video we want to share with you. This is Annapolis Road in Bowie near Route 197 and Route 3. So I don't know if, gentlemen, if you're able to see this video right now. This is the Bowie area where we know we also have seen, as you've been passing along, Tony, still pictures of huge trees that have come down in that area. Right now, I do not believe we have any reports of injuries, thank goodness, at this point. We know that the power outages are at least about 15 minutes ago were over about 1,200 residents there, 1,200 households there, rather. So again, this is the video that has just come into the 11 newsroom, possible tornadoes over the Bowie area. Gentlemen.
Tom, I can't see it. Is it the video with the wall cloud or?
It's kind of indistinct. It's just general rotation. It's nothing really distinct there. It's just sort of a broad beginning circulation. It looks like a rotation there in that cloud base, but again, kind of diffuse and shrouded maybe in some rain showers around the area as well, but definitely some rotation there. I think our director said we also have the Channel 4 DC, WRC chopper. Are they up that we can take pictures from? Oh, they're looking for damage? Okay, all right, so that was up in the Bowie area. And again, if you look at our radar here, I've got that line drawn. The initial cell came out of the Bowie area, went across Queen Anne's, down towards Shadyside, and that system now crossing the bay, heading over toward Talbot County. And then the next one down in the southern part of Anne Arundel County. This one here looks a little weaker, but it's definitely there. So a separate cell developing on a little more of a southern track coming across this area here. So you definitely want to watch out. These two areas of concern are definitely showing up as a rotation, at least indicated by radar, and something that we have to watch out. Notice also this one here to the north, sort of up near, heading in the general St. Michael's area. That may be trying to rotate as well. But this is the two main areas of concern that the National Weather Service has been warning for are the one near Deal now and the one approaching the shoreline there in Talbot County north of Tillman, and these are all moving east at about 25 miles an hour. So there's the one near Deal will be out over the bay and head east, and the one coming on shore will be moving across the western part there of Talbot County near Route 579. It looks like those areas there are definitely
Tom,
worth watching. Yes, sir.
If you If you take a composite radar loop on a wide shot, mm-hmm. you can actually see around 3 or 4 o'clock this afternoon the spin in the atmosphere. There's a little what we call vorticity maximum mm-hmm. that came out of, and that's just a little spot where the atmosphere is spinning, kind of like a whirlpool. And it's a little piece of energy that was up in southern Pennsylvania, and you can see the rotation as this line of storms developed, and that's what initially got the air spinning, and that's what created the energy.
I see.
You can
it, yeah,
clearly
yeah,
see the little yeah. vortmax there, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'll show the folks here. They're right there. This kind of spin that just dips down through there interacts with yep. the warm front most likely, and the bay breeze, as you mentioned. So, yeah, little weather impulse there that just kind of zips across central Maryland, now moving over onto the eastern shore. And you can notice that, again, it's going to be pretty nice once this gets out of here. The weather's going yeah. to quiet down quite a bit for the next few hours once this system passes by. But for now, we've got these warnings going on for southern Anne Arundel County until 6:45 for the eastern shore, which includes parts of Kent Island, but mostly in Talbot County there, north of Tillman, down over towards St. Michael's until 7 o'clock tonight. I'll put the radar on there. You see the really hot spots where we've got some very heavy rain in deal with that storm, and then the one approaching the shoreline of Talbot County. And then we'll put on the rotation here, the wind speeds, and you definitely get a feel for the winds blowing toward the radar site and away from the radar site, also up here.
What kind of speeds are you seeing on there on the gate to gate? I bet it's not real impressive when
they
you do
have
that.
It. Yeah, you're right. They I mean, all throughout the year we've been maybe getting up in the 70, 80 mile an hour wind speeds, but the shear on these is not impressive right now. I think that one yeah. definitely did weaken over the bay. The one near Deal now, and the latest radar return just looks like it's just clearing the shore there now.
Yeah,
and is about to come
shore.
Out over the water, out over the waters there, just in the Deal area north of Rosehaven, far southern part of Anne Arundel County. Everybody else in Anne Arundel County, I think things are quieting down quite a bit. Although there is that cell right there.
There's that
the
one little cell up there yeah. near Edgewater.
Yeah, yeah.
That, you know, it, there's no warning on that one, mm-hmm. but, I mean, it does look like it's spinning a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I wouldn't be surprised just given the nature of the atmosphere right now. And obviously down there, there's what we call directional shear in the atmosphere. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't be surprised if mm-hmm. there was a little funnel cloud in that one up there yeah. as well, even though there's no warning on that one at the present
yeah.
time.
These
and,
are the
you know, that
areas.
One that's yeah. over by Deal is might head down towards Tillman Island as well. So that whole yeah. area, St. Michael's, Tillman's yeah. Island, just because this one that Tom was talking about is going to pass soon. These other two are going to be heading your way in the next, I don't know, 15 minutes, 20 minutes?
Yeah, yeah, it's not going to take very long at all. They're moving at a pretty good clip here. This is the past 30 minutes of those two cells as they move through Deal and then across the bay toward the shore in Talbot County. So, again, we'll see if they reorganize, if they hold together. Either way, even if you don't get an actual tornado, strong damaging winds, straight line winds could
sure.
come with these storms for sure as they make their way through that area. So this is the broad view, and these are the warnings that are in effect. Again, the eastern shore until 7, the western shore, and I think that's going to probably be canceled down around Deal shortly because it's about to move out over the waters. Let me see if Sterling has done any update on that one. They're continuing at 6:30. They were continuing that warning capabilities in their Deal. That's no update on that yet. And Philadelphia over on the eastern shore at, well, this is a new update at 6:36. Severe thunderstorm possibly producing a tornado over Tillman Island, 9 miles east of Shadyside, moving southeast at 20. So, yep, that's
the one.
Still,
yeah.
still monitoring that. Again, not confirmed, radar indicated, so they're basing it on what we are seeing as well, the strong rotation being indicated and giving people over here on the eastern shore a heads up. This is a system that's had a history of producing some damage, possible tornadoes over here on the western shore. It's now reaching you folks near Sherwood, Tillman, and looks like maybe even a separate cell up near Claiborne, but the primary focus around that Sherman area there and moving onshore even as we speak at about to cross Route 33. Move over to Route 579 and perhaps bear down on the St. Michael's area as well. This is the past couple of minutes.
So, Tom, I was just going through my Twitter feed again. And again, if you want to look at this live with me, you folks go to my Twitter feed, Tony Pan, WBAL. So one of our old weather interns, his name is Robbie, and I forget his last name, Camerati, I forget his last name. Sorry, Robbie, if you're listening. He has a drone that he flies up during these severe weather situations.
Oh, man, be careful,
and
Robbie.
And he's got drone video of the storm passing by Edgewater, and you can definitely see the rotation and what looks like the wall cloud and maybe a funnel dropping down. So that is some dramatic. That's probably, if you have a drone, that's the safest way to do it, right? Fly the drone up there and let it take pictures. But that's the modern era. I'm getting drone pictures now.
Yeah, if you're far enough away. If you're far enough away, for sure.
20 years ago, if I told you I was going to post a drone video of a tornado, what would you have told me? Are you out of your mind?
And you got to hope that the drone survives. You probably, probably spent a lot of money on that thing, and I hope that it survives for sure. Okay, we got bells going off. I'm trying to see if we got any additional warnings being issued.
Yeah, go ahead and take
a look. Nothing at Philly, nothing
from
Sterling.
Tom, while you're looking into that, we have some more video we're being told in our controller. And before we go to the video, we have an update from BGE. Apparently, the outages have dropped down to 700. This is some tornado video, possible tornado video out of Bowie. From a viewer, Landy James, why don't you guys take a look at this if you see anything interesting in those clouds that you're seeing right there. From a viewer, Landy James out of Bowie. She says she got out of her car when she saw that and took cover. And she was out and about when she recorded that.
Well, that's
video.
The smart thing to do, right?
Right?
I mean, if you, it's an interesting discussion all the time about what you should do if you're in your car and you see a tornado coming. Now, the old conventional advice would have been to get out of your car and lie flat in a ditch on the side of the road.
Yeah.
I don't think I would do that.
No.
I mean,
cars have become so safe now.
Yes, I would stay in the car.
I would. I mean, we've seen video just in the past couple months of people being hit by a tornado in their car, the car being picked up, rolled over, and they get up and walk out of the car.
Wow.
I do think the car's safe.
I saw one of them drive away after that happened.
Yeah, I think that from the your seat belts, the airbags, all that stuff, it's probably safer than getting out of your car and being exposed, unless you can get into a sturdy building, really, somewhere nearby.
Yeah, well, if you can run to a sturdy building, of course, yes.
Yeah, for sure,
but, I mean, it's like those old, you remember back in the 70s, it was said that you should crack the windows in your house if a tornado was coming to equalize the air pressure.
Right.
Well, no. That's
stay away
not
from
true.
The windows.
I mean, don't open the windows. That's not going to save your house.
Yeah.
But, you know, that kind of advice used to be passed along a lot in the past.
I'll tell you guys, if I'm on the road in my car and I'm seeing a tornado, I don't
even want to imagine this.
I'm thinking about that.
I can't imagine the fear. But I'm glad you guys brought this up because I have wondered where
we
could
you
possibly be safe, even though I know I'm certainly not safe in my own mind.
Exactly.
Well, Deborah, you remember last year, Tom, I think you were on vacation. We had the tornado that went through the Annapolis area or just west of Annapolis, the big one. You were on the air with me that night, Deborah, and somebody sent me a picture. I don't know if you remember. We put it on the air. They were sitting at a stoplight, took a picture through their windshield of the tornado on the ground going by.
Wow. Yeah.
In the car.
I think I'm still stressed at seeing that video.
So the tornado warning for Anne Arundel County has expired. That's the good news for that. Yeah, we can definitely give Anne Arundel County the clear there. The storm coming off the county is going to be let go, is according to the National Weather Service. So I don't know why it hasn't dropped off of our map here yet. But on their chat room, they are saying that the Anne Arundel County tornado warning is expiring because I think it's moving out over the bay, essentially. It's moving away from land areas there and moving in the bay.
Yeah, it's not their responsibility. So maybe watch Philadelphia might pick up on that one.
Right. They may continue that one over on the Eastern Shore. They have not updated since 636, so that warning continues over there in Talbot County in the far southern part of Queen Anne's County. But again, it's mostly this area here that would be impacted, Tillman up to Sherwood to Claiborne to St. Michael's. I think we did we have reports of video damage attended?
On cue, Aunt, we have some brand new video from Bowie. Let's take a look at this video. Look at this here. This is some video coming in from Bowie of a trampoline in the air. Look at that there.
Oh, my
Look at that. That's a trampoline in the air, we're told, from a viewer in Bowie.
Wow.
Getting video of a trampoline in the air. Wow.
Hey, Tom.
Yes.
I've got an interesting question from one of our people on Twitter. Ask me this question, and I'll ask you the question, and maybe you can answer it with me. Yeah. It's from Timothy. He says, why didn't the National Weather Service issue a tornado emergency after somebody actually spotted the tornado and confirmed it? And here's my answer, and maybe, Tom, you can think about yours. Now, what they saw and what was reported to the National Weather Service was actually a funnel cloud. I don't think anybody actually saw the tornado on the ground.
Right.
When you see the tornado on the ground, that's when the National Weather Service issues a tornado emergency. There are actually two different kinds of tornado warnings. The kinds that Tom has been passing along to you, those are radar indicated. In other words, the radar can scan a storm so well now, we can see the indications that a tornado might be in there, but we don't know for sure. When somebody sees the tornado on the ground, then the Weather Service issues something called a tornado emergency, and that means there's no doubt. But nobody saw one on the ground. Is that correct, Tom?
That is correct, yeah. They saw a funnel cloud halfway down. And I think even in the emergency, I mean, if you could have a weak tornado, they might not issue an emergency unless they're sure it's going to do severe damage to it. So, you know, even a warning that's been spotted, if it's not, especially if it's in a rural area or it's not an emergency threat to human beings in the area, I think that emergency warning is issued for populated areas where extreme damage is expected or happening. Even, you know, whenever a National Weather Service issues a warning, it's happening. So the warning would be for emergency situation for damage ongoing that is going to happen. Funnel cloud or even a weak tornado may not trigger that sort of emergency warning from a National Weather Service. So, but so far it's been either radar indicated or funnel cloud spotted. We have had reports though of damage, so we've seen at least some spotty damage in the area. So it seems
like
something.
Thank you for that question. It's kind of interesting to be able to answer social media questions live on the air in this kind of a situation. It's it's an advancement that you know. We're very thankful we can do now, right? We got drone video, and we're talking to people on social media live on the air.
And I've also had some questions on Twitter asking why isn't the BWI terminal Doppler, and we just aren't having data out there. So I don't know. Either they're down or they're not functioning right now, or else our system isn't getting it. But I do not see any radar data coming out of BWI's terminal Doppler, which sometimes can be very good in these situations. Yeah, I think they must be down, not functioning in this situation. We have been able to get Andrews, their terminal Doppler, but it isn't working well either. So maybe these storms are a little bit higher up. The terminal Dopplers tend to be a little lower elevation, I suppose.
Probably.
But nothing coming out of there. Philly's a little too far away. Wakefield's too far away. Over at Dover, Delaware, we've been able to monitor some of the activity there. But again, they're not picking it up quite as good as Sterling has been able to pick it up. This system now moving onshore in Talbot County is, quite frankly, in an area where radar coverage isn't going to be great. You would think that the Dover site would get it. And this is Dover here. So it does look like they're picking up as best we can on this system, with the red moving away from Dover, Delaware, the green moving toward Dover, Delaware. And so you would see where we have the possibility of a system there with some rotation near Sherwood over on the eastern shore, moving in the general direction of St. Michael. So be on the lookout over there in St. Michael's for sure. This system that's come on shore looks like it's going to move in your general direction, crossing through the Sherwood area now. It may be aimed a little bit south of St. Michael's, but generally in that direction, coming across the northern part of Talbot County. I'd be taking shelter right now in those locations. And again, as we always mention, it's not too early to plan ahead, especially with one of these long-lived storms that's going to be coming across this entire area here. So if you're watching us, listening to us in Easton, be on the lookout. The same system with a history of producing funnel clouds and tornadoes is moving in the direction of St. Michael's and Easton, coming across northern Talbot County. Not as distinct for sure, but could reorganize and would even have straight line damaging winds if it holds together and comes across. The other one that came out of Deal and moving across the bay may well be weakening quite a bit, as it's not showing up as well right now, although Sterling.
Now, that's a distinct little cell, though, but the rotation doesn't look as. What about that one? While you were talking, I was looking around the storm to right around Queen Anne, Cordova, Denton. It would be just to the northeast of the one that's near Tillman Island, right at the tail end of that
Got any rotation on that one? Let's check it out and see if there's any rotation up there. It looks like a little trying there. That's the Dover site. That's Sterling.
Yeah.
Weak rotation maybe with that one for sure.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. All of these systems are showing, you know, an ability to spin a little bit, but they both, all of the systems right now, from my vantage point, look a lot weaker than they did just a few minutes ago. So
they
That's definitely some good news there. Philly has not updated. Sterling, Virginia has not updated since about 5-10 minutes ago. So there's
when does the warning expire for around St. Michael's? Is 7 o'clock?
That one goes until 7 o'clock. So that's the only one we have going right now. Everything else in Anne Arundel County has been dropped.
They might just let that go and expire. You know.
Yeah, see what happens as it moves inland here. But that one goes until 7, and we've been monitoring that one pretty well with a couple of different areas of possible rotation indicated, one on the northern edge here, and then the other one coming north of Tillman, heading in the general direction of St. Michael's. That, I think, would be the most worrisome one, but it too, looks a lot weaker than it did even just a few minutes ago. Mostly heavy rain now, and not even a whole lot of lightning in the past. Which is kind of strange.
Yes, there was no lightning in these practically.
Yeah, and a lot of time you'll get lightning, you know, you can even monitor the strengthening or weakening of a storm with the lightning strikes, but not much lightning, not much hail potential with these either. The very warm air must be, mitigating that. It's mostly just this warm front with the spin and that vortex coming through and complicated by the bay breezes, so it seems like...
All that put together.
So a little rotation there, maybe a hint of rotation there. Everything moving east at about 25 to 30 miles an hour. Northern and western sections of Talbot County are the warning spots right now. And that warning, as you can see, goes until 7 p.m.
While we're waiting for that warning, to watch, and Tom, I'll let you do a little analysis while I talk for a second here. I'm one of our last podcasts, I brought this up, and I'm going to bring it up now because it's appropriate. If you're a boater, you really need to get a weather band radio on your boat. You cannot rely on your cell phone to get these warnings to come through, these marine warnings or the tornado warnings that come out. Because if you're on the water, a lot of times the cell, you know, reception isn't very good. And sometimes, quite frankly, they don't even come through on your cell phone. But you know what always goes through? The radio signal. Go get yourself a weather band radio. Have it on your boat. They're like 30 or 40 bucks. It can literally save your life. I don't understand why a lot of boaters don't have that now. Maybe it's just because they rely on the cell phone technology, but I'm telling you, a weather band radio is essential if you're going to be on the Chesapeake Bay in the summertime.
I would say so, indeed. Now, Philly has just updated and continues the tornado warning for the system in Talbot County moving toward Easton. It was located, they pinpointed about what we did over Tillman Island, 12 miles west of Easton, moving in that direction at 20 miles an hour. So figure this storm system here, folks, is moving in your direction at about 20 miles an hour. That means, let's put it out there at 20 miles an hour. These are the timings of this system moving on, get it back there, moving on shore. So you can kind of see when it's going to get in your location. St. Michael's at about 7 o'clock, right, 2 minutes after or so. Easton about 7:25 if it keeps moving at this speed. And then all the way over into Caroline County as we get past about 7:40 or so, 7:45, moving over there toward Newton in Caroline County. So that's the system that has a warning until 7 p.m. for Talbot County. And the system is moving in the general direction of St. Michael's. So definitely heed the warning and take shelter right now. The system is a dangerous one. It's shown some signs of damage here on the western shore, and now it's plowing through that area over there on the eastern shore. Not quite as strong as it was for sure, but still capable of producing some damage, whether straight line wind damage or rotation. Much less rotation being indicated now. I think what you could see here is maybe a little bit indicated right in this little spot here, just to the northeast of Tillman, that area right there. Would be what's left of it, I suppose. It doesn't appear to be as strong, nearly as strong as it was when I say it was over in Bowie and that location coming across Shadyside, but definitely something.
It certainly doesn't, does it? It doesn't have the same look to it.
Nope.
As a matter of fact, that storm that's behind it almost has that, the one that's over on shore now near Shadyside, that one almost has that look. to it.
Yeah, that one coming across central Anne Arundel County for sure, dropping southeast. But they don't, they don't have a warning out for that.
They don't have a warning on that one, no.
But yeah, for sure, that one definitely looks. And even the one right up in here coming across east of McDaniel over toward Tunis Mills, that one has definitely some rotation with it. But not apparently not as much of a threat as the one that's bearing down on the St. Michael's area. The one there north of Tillman over towards St. Michael's appears more erratic or just kind of mixed, you know, messed up as far as its track across the bay and not really being able to organize much again. This one to the
north.
And
that's a good sign. What Tom is saying, that's a good sign, yes.
Yeah, for sure. This one here.
When the cells become distinct, and they have structure on the radar, I guess that's the only way I can explain it.
Yeah,
when they become mishmashed, like what's happening over there around Easton and St. Michael's, it's not. I'm not saying it's not dangerous, and there could be, you know, a water spout or something in there. It's just not the signature that you were seeing when it was on land coming across Anne Arundel County.
Right,
it's just not.
For sure. But that warning goes until 7 p.m. there, and if we continue to see this weakening trend with any luck, we'll be able to give you the all clear. Yeah, the highest tops right now, interestingly enough, are these one here, Shadyside, right now, up to 31,000 feet. So again, when we say highest tops, it's the storm billowing up 31,000 feet into the atmosphere, and the higher it goes, the stronger the storm, whereas these over on the eastern shore are much weaker, much shorter, not getting up past 23,000 feet. So strongest storm system showing up on our radar right now is the one over near Shadyside. This is not the initial one that went through with a possible tornado a few minutes ago, but this is a second cell that's coming through that area right now and poses some damage. Deb?
Yeah, I just want folks to know, if you're looking at these images that are live on the screen right now, this is Bowie. And so this was the area that was first affected by the power of the storm, which was, I would imagine this was just before 6 o'clock, maybe 5:30, between 5:30 and 6 o'clock. So you can see, now I don't know if you saw this earlier when we were broadcasting, but we've talked about this trampoline, right? This trampoline that was carried, and there was an image of the trampoline. Now, we don't know if it was that person's or if it was carried to this particular yard, but you can see these huge historic trees that are down on cars there. Again, this is the Bowie area, and some very old trees that have just come down. Again, at this point, we don't have any reports of injuries, thank goodness, but you can see the storm has passed. People are out there surveying the area, taking a look at their car to see if their car, that gentleman right there, to see if his car is going to make it and get him to work tomorrow, if he's going to work tomorrow, and not with that tree on it. But, you know, a lot going on in the Bowie area where they're out now surveying the damage, Andre.
It's a close-up of the shot, this from the live pictures from Bowie, that guy. He just went into his car surveying any damage, if, you know, potential damage, because it's right next to a car that has a tree on top of the car.
Wow.
And we're seeing a lot of pictures like this.
This is another good time to bring this up as well, since we're kind of waiting out the warning here. If you have a multi-level house, and most people sleep on the top floor of their house, right? Their bedroom's on the top floor. If you're in a severe weather situation at night, and you know that there is the possibility, if we're talking about it on TV, of something like this happening, you should sleep on the bottom level that night just in case. Because if a tree like that falls on your house, the first place that's going to get crushed is the top floor. And if you've got something between you and that tree falling, like the top floor of your home, obviously you're going to be a lot safer. So sleep downstairs. That's my advice in a severe weather situation.
Apparently, we have some additional video, guys, of this possible tornado forming. This is in Bowie, taken about an hour ago. And you can see this right now, the formation up there in the clouds. You can also hear, we can't hear it right now, but you can also hear someone in the video telling people to smartly get into their bathtub.
Let me just quickly show you another cell that Philadelphia is worried about. The National Weather Service in Philadelphia is a little worried about this cell in Caroline County. They feel like this is now the strongest one on their radar, south of Denton, north of American Corner. You can see the more distinct rotation there. I wouldn't be surprised if they quickly pop a warning. We'll see if they do or not. But they said on their chat that they're monitoring this very closely. This one, again, is moving gradually to the east. So if you're in that part of central Caroline County, south of Denton, over toward Andersontown, you want to be taking shelter immediately. And even over into western Delaware, it looks like it's going to quickly get across Caroline County and maybe make it into parts of Delaware here. So some very strong rotation being indicated by the radar there. This system, I'm still monitoring it out of Sterling. So the green is moving toward Sterling's radar and the red is moving away. And you can see where there may be some strong rotation there right in the middle of Caroline County. So watch out.
Sure,
take shelter.
Like it.
Yeah, it definitely looks like it. And they indicated the one in Talbot is much less concerned now. That one definitely has weakened, as we said, and hopefully will continue to weaken as it passes there just to the south of St. Michael's and heads over toward Easton with mostly rain. This one in central Caroline County has the potential to do some damage, though, as well. The radar is trying to pick up on the beam there. Let me go over to the Dover, Delaware site and
see
if
check out Dover. Yeah.
A little more complicated, not as clear-cut on the Dover, interestingly enough.
I wonder why that would be. You'd think you'd get a better picture of it from Dover.
Yeah,
but maybe
be.
The rotation is up high, like you said.
Right.
But the radar beam shoots up a couple thousand feet up into the air. So we're switching radar sites. Now, Dover is closer to this storm, but
yeah.
Sterling, Virginia, is further away.
Let me
so
go to
maybe
Dover.
The rotation is at the top of the storm
and
not at the bottom of the storm. That's why Sterling's radar is picking it up a little better.
Now I'm going higher up here, and you can see the wind speeds are picking up. So this is much higher into the atmosphere.
Oh, there you go. Yeah,
and you can start to see more of that rotation there coming down. Watch out in Andersontown for sure. South of Denton, this area in here, definitely would be on the lookout for possible damaging conditions in that location. No warning issued for this location yet, but again, National Weather Service up in Philadelphia, which monitors the eastern shore, is keeping a close eye. They've issued a severe thunderstorm warning for it, but not a tornado warning. And again, they have told us that the one in Talbot County will expire here at the top of the hour. They are not planning on reissuing that. And then it's just a thunderstorm warning in Caroline County for now over onto the western parts of Delaware. And with any luck here in the next minute or so, we'll be in the clear as far as tornadoes go, but we'll continue to monitor for sure this system here in Caroline County. It looks kind of nasty there, so take shelter over on the eastern shore in Caroline County, northern Talbot County. Storms appear to be getting toward the end of their life cycle, but can't give you quite the all clear just yet, other than the fact that we have tornado warnings. The tornado warning, there you go, in Talbot County has expired, and now it's just a severe thunderstorm warning over on the eastern shore. So that's a long-lasting warning that started in Bowie, went down across Shadyside, made it all the way into Talbot County for sure, and it looks like it did some damage along the path. We'll have to wait and see if there are any official tornadoes verified with those, but for now, all of the tornado warnings have expired. I'm going to give it to Devin Andre to see.
You know that no tornado watch issued.
Yep.
Nothing, no severe thunderstorm watch. And again, it's worth bringing this point up again. Just because there's no official watch out or anything like that, obviously doesn't mean that something like this can't happen, because it can. And
we did have impact weather indicated today because of the potential. We notice in the outlook we were just in the marginal risk area. But again, I mean, look, any severe thunderstorm can produce a tornado. You don't have to have warnings and watches issued. You got to take any severe thunderstorm seriously, including this one right now in Caroline County, for sure.
Excellent point.
Yep. Tony, hey, thanks for all the help there, for sure.
All right, Tom, take it easy, guys.
All right.
Be safe, everyone.
All right,
bye-bye.
You too.
Thanks, Tony.
Yep.
All right, great job, you guys. Thank you both for that coverage, and we will continue to monitor this storm and this situation and what is happening on the ground there as well.
That's right, and should anything happen, should we need to notify you, we will, of course, break into programming and let you know how you can keep you and your family.